Cola Pops, and welcome back to the channel. If you're new and you're stopping by, you've just entered Cola's Destiny. Please don't leave without showing the channel some love. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe to the channel. Please turn on your notifications so that you will see when I post some new content. Now, to all of my old subscribers, I thank you so much for your love and your support. The engagement is like out of this world. I love it. I love talking to you guys on here. I would like to shout out Tammy Winkle. Girl, we got a connection on here that is like unmatched. You can follow her on her page as well, and I'll leave it right here. She's amazing. She's such a sweet soul. Following up with what I told you I would do is the fall looks. So I'm continuing to do that. Now, some of the looks are going to be a little bit more challenging for you. Some of them are going to be easy. Just practice and you will get it down pat. So today I am going to be jumping into my Jaclyn Hill palette, the Volume 2 palette. And I honestly forgot I had this palette. I did, I don't remember which video it was, but it was, I think it was the last one where I was trying to do the red. And I forgot that I had the Jaclyn Hill palette with a red in there. I actually went, I was in Sephora and I was like, oh my God, that's so pretty. And I was like, what palette is that? She's like, the Jaclyn Hill 2 palette. And I was like, oh, so that's why I buy things in duplicate and I have to return them because, like, I'm dumb. Anyway, so all of these colors are so beautiful in here, and I don't know why I had her hiding up. I think it's because, like, I really wasn't going anywhere, to be quite honest. I was, really wasn't doing my makeup for anything besides YouTube. So I try to change up the palettes on here, and sometimes some of them get pushed to the wayside, so sorry, but so I got some time. I wonder if that's my favorite thing to say. I really do say that a lot. So I got some time. Don't know what I'm doing as usual. Don't really have anything in mind. I just know that another video needs to be done. I'm thinking of doing something purple and orange. So yeah, so I don't want to run into the mistake I made in my last video where it looks a certain way in the pan, and when I put it on, it's coming out different. So I don't want to be using purple and putting it on my eyes and it's coming out turquoise. So let me go ahead and swatch. I think I only really want to use two or three colors for this. So I want to try a deep purple first. Ooh, this is very deep. Deep. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with, honestly, I can't see, guys. I'm not wearing, so I'm gonna start off with this purple here. This one here. So let's try. So I'm gonna do that purple, and I'm actually, okay, so good thing that I swatched it, because that one came out a little pink. The orange that I'm swatching came out a little pink. So I'm going to use purple, and then I'm going to head over to these two oranges to see which one is more pigmented on me. Most likely this one, and then this one, these two here. And I will probably add, so that's one, two, three. So I'll probably add either this lavender or this pink beside to put in my form for a transition. So let's get it started. So there's a visitor that wants to say hi.
Hi.
They can't see you.
You know me from the other videos.
And guess, tell them what you're missing today.
My tooth.
Where did it go?
And my dad's. I forgot it in the freezer. By the time I get it, there's gonna be ice chunks on it.
There's gonna be ice chunks on your tooth? Oh wow, psych or something. Okay, bye.
Bye. Now goodbye.
Okay, now goodbye. Okay, so we're just gonna start off with a little bit of the purple because this really seems like it's a lot. Actually, on a cotton, tell me something, forget something. I need to bake under my eyes so that if I have any fallout, honestly, so gonna let me really be out here with fallout all over my cheeks. So I'm just gonna be using my Laura Mercier powder in honey. Since we're baking, why not bake my nose? I don't know how I forgot this. Don't know how I forgot. Anyway. Like I say, Soika sometime. Alright, now let's start. You see why you have to start with a little bit? Because it's really pigmented. But I really want it to be deep, so I might add some black. I'm not sure yet. And guys, look how gentle I'm tapping, because this is really, really pigmented and I don't want this to be a disaster. I'm literally just tapping it like that. So, I'm thinking, you know what I'm thinking? Cut crease. Why not? Okay. I'm going to switch to some brushes that I might would want to use. So I'm going to be switching to the M507 brush, and that's by Morphe. I think I want to add a little tiny bit of black just to deepen it a little, and I'm just tapping very lightly. Lord, I tapped lightly and look what happened. But we'll just blend it right out and it just deepened it nicely. It didn't bring too much black to the purple. It just deepened that purple really, really deep. So I'm just gonna go back in with my Morphe 505. And diffuse it some more. Like that. I decided that I want the look to be more dragged out, so I'm just going to use the same brush. I didn't put any more product, and I'm just going to be dragging it to diffuse it out. Initially, I was going to keep it more rounded in my eyes, but I think I want to drag it out. Okay, now I said I was gonna go in with one of the lilacs or a pink. I'm gonna try the lilac first, and if it doesn't brighten it enough, then I'll go ahead and I'll use the pink. And the lilac worked. Now, when you're building your shadow, you don't want to leave out, you don't want to leave out this section here. You want to make sure that you're diffusing your shadow in there. You don't want to leave in here bare. You want your entire face to look like it's all come together. So always make sure that you get inside there. So how you would, I guess as a guideline, this is where your nose bridge is. You want to kind of follow that. You want to follow that where your shadows, but not obviously down on your nose. Okay. Two colors so far, yeah? Two colors. Now I want to cut my crease. Go ahead and cut my crease really quick. So now that my crease is cut and I parted a little bit, I'm gonna go ahead and add that, I think, the brighter orange first. Let's see. And I'm going to be using the JH42 brush. You've heard me call out the names of these brushes before. It is actually the Jaclyn Hill line of brushes. So she has her palettes, she has her brushes, and I actually like them. Oh! Okay. Makeup.
Makeup video?
Yeah.
Do you need a little break from the video?
No, I don't need a video. I don't need a break.
Okay, go make a video here.
I'll call you back.
Alright.
Okay.
But it has to be after 1 o'clock, never meet until 1.
Don't tell me when to call you. I'll call you when I want to call you. You tell them. You tell them that Nicola is calling you, that you have to take the call.
I'll just message my supervisor, let
him know that I gotta take a call. Okay. Bye. I am actually really, really pleasantly surprised with these colors. Like, I've only really used this palette for the black and the magenta and the browns. I didn't ever touch any of the other colors, and I parked the palette. I'll be using this. If you see this in a couple of videos, don't be surprised. I really like this. Okay, so I'm gonna actually take that purple and marry it into this orange before I get carried away. You see how many times I told you guys, don't stress about makeup. It's not that serious. It really isn't. Like, I never thought I would wear purple and orange together, but I am. And it works. And it's all trial and error, and really just make it your own. It's really not that serious.
gonna add some more orange because I lost a little bit right here. It's not that serious, guys, trust me. You just have to play around and find your comfort zone. So if you're a person that likes a lot of neutrals, play around with the browns and the burgundies, because you don't have to just use brown to say that it's neutral. You can use burgundies, you can use blacks, you can use pumpkin, like a pumpkin-y orange, which I have an idea. Next time, I'm gonna do, I have an idea. I have an idea. Oh, this is so freaking pretty. But see, now my dilemma is I don't know what I want to do next. I brought it all the way. Look how pretty that is. So wow. It's all about just really taking your time. Take your time. And experiment. And have fun. Doesn't have to be stressful. Why do I feel like I hear somebody behind me? How did I know?
I'm back.
You're back? Are you back to speak to my cola pops, or are you just back to bother me?
Speak.
You're gonna speak?
Mm-hmm.
What are you gonna tell them?
Guess what? I am super fast.
You're super fast,
super
but they can't. Rules. They can't see you.
Oh, oh. This side they can see better. I'm super good at Smash Bros. And
come
I'm
closer.
Super fast.
What do you want to tell them now?
I'm super good at Smash Bros. And I'm super fast.
I can't even understand you. How do you expect them to understand you? What did you say?
I'm super good at Smash Bros. And I'm super fast.
You're super good at Smash Bros. What the heck is Smash Bros?
A game me and Kamani play.
You and
Kamani.
Oh, and you're super fast? Or you're super fast? You're super fast.
I'm super fast.
That's what you're saying. Fast.
I'm saying fast.
You're saying fast.
No, I'm not. I'm saying fast.
Get out of here. Bye. Can you leave? Just to clean up the line, which is not really a line, I'm just gonna use my Charlotte Tilbury bronzer. And already clean off the brush and just add the bronzer. I did tell you guys before that you can use the bronzer as a transition shade, or you can use it all over your eye. Made a difference, didn't it? Okay, do we add liner today? I'm going to add some liner. I'm gonna add my... Ooh, I have a plan. So I added my wing liner, but I'm going to add a little bit of a zhuzh, but I want that black to dry first. So what I'm going to do in the meantime is just continue on with the bottom of my eyes or my brushes. So I'm going to take the same brushes and use the same colors on the bottom as I did on the top. Your mom's calling me. So now that I added
the bottom to match the top. I am going to add some white liner to the top. Let's see how it's, I hope I don't mess this shit up, honestly. Ooh, wished me all the luck in the world because I need it just about now. I'm just gonna dust away my face. So I lined my lips with an orange lip liner. It has no name, it's literally from the beauty supply store. It's just an orange lip liner and I'm just filling in with a dose of colored gloss. So over top the dose of colors, I'm going to add another gloss. I'm just gonna put my Fenty Beauty over that. Hope you guys love the look. My little ponytail. Do you guys like me with a ponytail? I know I look a lot younger with a ponytail, but that's Sarika. Sarika sometime. That should be my channel name. Sarika sometimes. I hope you guys really like this look. I hope and pray you guys are following all of the coronavirus protocols. Please wear your mask. Please social distance. Don't go out in crowd numbers that you shouldn't go out in, because we all need to get better. We all need to stay safe. The world needs to open up again. Period. So until next time, guys, I love you and stay blessed.